Naik on the right.
I am Fazal Sarang. By profession, I am an architect. My question is to Mr. Dr. Zakir Naik. Is the non-vegetarian food is the only reason for the heart disease?
The brother asked a very good question. That is non-veg the only reason for the heart disease? And this was spoken by Mr. Zaveri, that flesh, animal flesh, chicken, mutton, beef causes heart disease. It can cause, he's right. And he further said, there is not a single vegetable source which contains cholesterol. If you tell that to any doctor, not the ideological vegetarian, they'll agree. Heart disease is caused when the diet contains more fat and more cholesterol, irrespective whether it is veg or non-veg. Irrespective. Non-veg. Foods do contain high cholesterol. But even vegetable foods, groundnut oil, cashew nut, coconut, ghee, butter, all this, even a common housewife knows. You know why? There are ads in the media. Half safola oil will not cause heart disease. Indicating the other oils cause heart disease. Simple. You don't have to be a doctor. It's a blatant 100% falsehood. I, being a medical doctor, I challenge Mr. Rashmi Vaidavari to answer, does butter contain fat or not? And the doctors do tell the people suffering heart disease, don't have fat, don't have butter, don't have groundnut oil, don't have cashew nut oil. So where did he get this idea from? From these books. This book he gave to me. Correct? This book you gave to my brother. Who gave? Mr. Salesha. Mr. Salesha gave this book. In this book also it is mentioned the same thing, that there is no cholesterol in vegetables. I'm sorry if I thought, because the first time I'm meeting Mr. Zaveri here, if he didn't give these books, I apologize. No, it's okay. But one thing, that all these books are published by Jain organization and distributed in Bombay. Cheap. Cheap. Yes, I'm not
please,
blaming.
Please.
I don't want to hurt
let
anyone's feeling.
Let us not
feeling.
Have a dialogue across the this thing.
I'm not going to hurt anyone's feeling. I'm sorry, I didn't want to say that, but I was compelled. I don't want, if it's not, you said not written by Jain, it's not written.
No, you said, Dr. Zakir, that I should reply.
You will have a chance in your question answer time.
Sir, I'll let you allow you time. You know, in your time, you can respond back. No, I'll allow you to respond back anything you want in your time.
And I request the chairman to give me half minute more. I will disturb half minute more.
No, he's too smart. We'll not give him half a minute more.
See, because so many allegations, he told egg is the cause. Egg does contain cholesterol. It's rich in cholesterol. But it's not the major cause. Today's research and medical books also say that the cholesterol in the egg is not the major villain. It is the saturated fat in which you fry the egg, butter, ghee, lard, which is the main villain. If you don't have this frying in ghee, butter, the less chances of having ischemic heart disease by egg. And today, amongst the population, 2/3 of the population are non-responders to cholesterol. The moment there's high intake of cholesterol, like taking egg, the liver immediately cuts its own production. And the level that reaches the blood is the same. There are 1/3 people who are responders to cholesterol. They have a problem. They should abstain from yolk of the egg. Otherwise, even if you have 1 or 2 egg a day, you will not have heart diseases. And if you have it with bacon, with pork, then the problem. If you fry in ghee, you'll have a problem. If you fry in groundnut oil, you'll have a problem. Causing baldness. I don't want to give examples. Even if you check here, there are many people who are bald. There are great philosophers who are bald. I don't want to take their names. I don't want to hurt your feelings. So this thing is just a research which is based on illogical assumption. A research should be practical. And the associate factor for heart disease is also alcohol as well as smoking. These two are also one of the associate causes for heart diseases. Yes, in America, heart diseases are more in non-veg because they have fats. Quran says don't have an excess, this problem will be solved. Secondly, the vegetarians of America, they are fluent. It's a woke to be a vegetarian because, you know, to buy veg food is expensive. If you turn Mercedes car, you have status. If you have veg food, it is status there. about 3 to 7% are vegetarian in America. Less than 1% are pure vegetarian. Less than 1%. Because they are fluent and they are rich, they take more care of hygiene. And many vegetarian ideologically also, like even Mr. Ashmi Azaveri may agree that alcohol is prohibited, smoking is prohibited. Because of associated factors, the case of heart disease in vegetarian is less. But anyone who has food which is rich in cholesterol or fat, irrespective whether it is veg or non-veg, he will have heart disease. To prevent it, follow the guidance in the Quran in Surah Taha, chapter number 20, verse number 81, that do not commit excesses. That reminds me of a story. In school, we had learned that there was a religious priest who ate excessive food, and he had 64 laddus. And when he came back, his wife said, that why don't you have furan chutki, some digestive? So he says, Are baoli akal nahi banke che bachcho ki mata agar churan chutki ke liye jagah hoti to main do laddu aur na bhok leta.